Hello. Okay, all are ready to learn the new topic today? Yes, I'm Yogita. Let us start a subject today. Subject is psychiatry nursing, and today we are learning about a separation anxiety disorder. It's very common in a very small young children. What do you mean by now separation anxiety disorder? The word itself will understand when you separate. You will get anxiety. So that's the reason, separate anxiety disorder. Now, when the child is separating from a very close attached figures, parental figures, then they are developing a excessive irrational anxiety or fear. This is what called separation anxiety disorder. Now, what's the clinical feature, a characteristic of a child with separation anxiety disorder? Now, the child may cry excessively. The child may cry excessively, and it is very difficult to manage the child. Child may develop a nightmare, awakening in sleep. Child may not ready to go to the sleep without the close caring parental figures or attached figures. Child have a nightmare, and a child is not ready to do any activity or any work without the closing caring figures. And also we can see that a child will have excessive cry, and because of that child is not able to take any food. Child is refusing to take the food. Only one business, that crying. Okay. So this is the feature of a child with separation anxiety disorder. Now how we can manage? We can give an individual counseling to the child where we'll understand the child and make the child to understand the opportunity which is really required for the child healthy growth and development. For example, we can see separation anxiety disorder just when you leave a small child for the school a very first day, or like they're going to the pre-KG very first day, we can imagine. We can't expect imagination. Mother may expect I'll go and drop my child to the school and I'll come back. But the reality is child will be screaming, crying, they're throwing the bag. They don't leave the mother hand. They don't want to go inside the classroom. They'll come near the window. They'll come near the door and they'll start crying. See, this will be there for another few days. So that child will expose to the new environment. They'll get settled. Okay, this is what called separation anxiety disorder. Very clearly we can see. So here we need a individual counseling where we'll make the child to understand the opportunity. Why you're going to school? Why you're going to any other classes to learn? So these all things you make the child understand, that will be a great help for the child. Parental counseling is required. So here, chances are there sometimes parents are overprotective about their children. Because of that, child may not develop any autonomy. So here, educate the parents that provide certain freedom or opportunity to the children so that they're able to do their work. Family counseling is important, where we need to train the family members to have a healthy family functioning in the family. So that a family will be a supportive measure to the child. Then we can give definitely certain behavioral measures, play therapy to the child to divert their mind and mold their behavior. Now related to that, we can see phobic anxiety disorder in children. The phobic anxiety disorder in children is where the children are having excessive irrational fear to certain animals like insects or some kind of animals, night. Regarding the death, they'll get excessive fear, but nothing to do much about in this, because when they grow elder, like when they reach the age of teenage, automatically and gradually this fear will come down. Next is social anxiety disorder. Here, a child is feeling excessive fear when they meet any social gathering, when they meet any strangers, where the child is not able to face. I can give you an example, like maybe the mother is getting ready to go for any wedding function where they will dress up very beautifully and she'll make her little daughter as a princess. So they'll dress up very well when they'll go to the function. Now the child is totally scared, a child is having fear about the strangers, child will not leave freely. Child don't leave the mother hand, will not move here and there from the mother. So mother also now irritated, mother don't know how to handle, child is simply crying. Oh, see that they dressed up well, the makeup, everything was waste now. See, mother is exhausted to handle the child. See, this is called a social anxiety disorder, where the child is feeling excessive fear, child is not able to face the stranger. I mean, all these cases, what we can do? We can give a assurance to the child, provide a behavioral therapy to the child to mold the behavior, make them to be like very firm in the behavior, give a reassurance and support to the child. That's all is enough, because when we do all these things, gradually when they grow up, all this fear and excessive anxietiness will be come down, and they are able to lead a normal life. In case if they have excessive, extremely anxiety where they're not able to manage, only in that case occasionally we can give anxiolytics, anti-anxiety tablet like diazepam to the child, so that we are able to manage the child in some extent. So this is what we learned today: separation anxiety disorder, phobic anxiety disorder, and social anxiety disorder in children. I hope you understood. A very simple topic. With the terms itself, once you understand the term, you're able to write your answer. Separation anxiety, when you're separated from the parental figure, you're closely caring, attached figures. Phobic anxiety, you're having a fear towards certain objects, yeah, certain situation, yeah, animals. Social anxiety disorder, where you're having a fear about the society or strangers. I hope the concept is very clear to you all and you understood the topic. So keep watching, and I'll catch you in a different video with a different new topics. Thank you. Bye.